70 years since the first Horse of the Year show, and finding someone who was there, such a privilege to meet, a winner from that first show. Does it feel like 70 years ago?
Well, I don't think it does feel like 70 years ago, actually.
And to think the event has changed. There you were in a stadium in North London.
Yes, that's right. And it was about the first indoor stadium that I'd ridden in, I think. And it was quite exciting.
Put it into how big was the event? Because obviously, 4 years after the war, it was a very different time, and you know, rationing and everything going on. So for the horse world, how a significant event was the 1949 Horse of the Year show?
I think it was very significant because horses, don't forget, played a huge part at home and in the war, you know, and so everybody rode. And so everybody was quite excited to have a championship show.
And for you, how did you end up being in the show?
Well, you had to qualify. You qualified from around England. And in fact, Legend had won the International Horse Show 3 years running, and we'd retired him because he'd won so much. And younger ponies might come and beat him. But my parents pulled him out of retirement, particularly for this show.
And so for you, I mean, obviously you've written books about him. How significant a horse was he in the time then? If he was always winning, was he that special?
Well, he was that special because he was my pony. My grandmother bred him, and I was brought up with him. And he was difficult. He backed me off as often as not. But he was a great friend.
Now you see the show where it is now. Can you imagine the scale that the show is now and coming back here in 70 years on?
No, it's incredible, really. Because it has, everything has changed. I mean, horses play a much less part in daily life than they did. And so people were very excited about horses. And actually, I came out of the ring having won, and Harry Llewellyn, you know Harry Llewellyn, he came up to me and he said, "Well done, little girl." And he shook my hand and he said, "Would you like to ride a real horse now?" "Yes," I said. And he put me on Fox Hunter, and he put a fence up in the collecting ring, not a big one, you know, quite big. And he said, "Go on, jump it." And I jumped Fox Hunter over about six fences in the collecting ring.
In that year?
But yes, as I came out of the ring. He just put me on Fox Hunter.
One of the greatest...
He was going in to the show jumping class, followed mine. And of course...
And you've also written a book, which you're going to be presenting to the winner of a class tonight.
Yes, yeah. I've written the book from a child's point of view. Because winning rosettes, you know, it's one thing, but actually living with a pony and all that sort of thing is good. But then the pony tells the story. Second part of the book is the pony telling the story, and he can explain what it was like in the war, seeing an aeroplane, what was an aeroplane, what were bombs. And the pony talks to other horses and finds out what's going on in that period.
It's an absolute privilege to see you here, and wonderful memories. And to think riding Fox Hunter, that is very special.
Special.
That was special.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.